February is Black History Month, and for the next 4 weeks, City News will be profiling Black Canadians and highlighting their contributions to Toronto and beyond. We begin tonight with the story of Toronto's first Black female city councillor. Tammie Sutherland speaks with Beverley Salmon about the racial roadblock she faced on the way to success.
I was teased, called the N-word, and I went home and I got my mom's talcum powder and I put it all over my arms and my face, and at that moment I just wanted to be white.
Just had enough.
Yeah, it was just a horrible, humiliating feeling.
Beverley Salmon was teased and taunted as one of the only Black children in her North Toronto school. Decades later, she would become the first Black female city councillor in Toronto, representing the very same neighborhood where she grew up in the grip of racism.
But it was Cassandra's appreciation for one song that made her a target opening night.
I was playing Minnie the Moocher, classic Blues Brothers song.
Around 11 p.m., she was confronted by three women leaving the grounds.
A lady with a child in her hand came up to me, smacked me in the face and said, "Don't play that."
She says the women, who were Black, shouted that a white girl could not play that song. Cassandra says she pushed away the woman who hit her and was hit again.
Her daughter came up from out of nowhere and punched me twice in the side of the face.
Ginger Slepsky's two girls helped her take off her long-sleeved shirt so that we could see the bruises and the scratches.
I thought it was so animalistic, so violent, and I'm so afraid for these girls to just get out and walk the streets.
Police say Slepsky was savagely beaten on Sunday as she drove through the North Side. She says when she pulled up to Concord Street, a group of girls threw a pop bottle at her car.
And I was mad. I knew they were younger. You know, I thought they were probably about in her early 20s. And I got out and I said, "What is your problem?"
She says the four girls were African American.
They yelled, "Shut up, white." And then the other one said, "Get that white."
Slepsky says she tried to get back in her car, but the girls grabbed her by the hair.
Then they all got on top of me, and all their hands were just wrapped up in my hair, and they kept telling each other, "Kick her in the head, kick her head in the concrete." I do feel like it was very racially motivated.
Slepsky also has torn ligaments in her shoulder from this attack, and that's a real problem because she's an electrician, and at this point she can't move her arms, she can't move her shoulders, and she's worried she won't be able to go back to work. She's concerned about providing for her two daughters. We do know tonight those four teens were arrested. All of them were charged with ethnic intimidation.